Yeah, what's up? Me Muck here, and I'm here with the beautiful Marie Doll. How are you, sweetheart?
I'm good, thank you. You're too kind. Thank you.
Ah, she's so sweet. All right, so tell me, you're a Houston native here, you know, born and raised, I'm assuming. Like, you do this, I assume, for like a hobby, a living. I mean, just go, how did you get started and all that?
Well, first, I was actually born in Monterrey, Mexico, and so I do speak Spanish, and I came here to the U.S. when I was about 7 years old, so I have been here for a while. So, I mean, yeah, technically, you could say that I was raised here, so I am a Texas native, and I started cosplaying, like, about 7 years ago, and, you know, started just as a hobby, just like anybody else. Mostly. And I started cosplaying with my best friend. Her mom showed me how to sew, how to work a sewing machine. So ever since then, I've been making my own costumes. And, you know, each year I kind of level up, you know, I would say. So it's like I'm a wizard and I just level up each year. That's how I got started. And now I'm a wizard and, you know, I hang out at the cons and I cosplay. It is a hobby slash job now. Because at the conventions, I am stuck behind the booth from 10 to 5. So it can be kind of, sometimes I get a little sad because, you know, I want to go out and explore and do stuff and hang out with my friends. But it's just one of those things that I'm still happy doing it. So I guess it's better than not doing it.
Exactly. Well, that's cool. You did, man, I don't know, countless cosplays over the years. I guess, tell me which one is, like, your favorite, and also which one was, like, the most, like, time-consuming or the most difficult to make?
My favorite is usually, like, the more simple ones. So, maybe, like, a bodysuit. I really like wearing Invisible Woman. Because, you know, it's just my wig, my bodysuit, my gloves, and I'm good to go. One of the most intricate ones is the Morrigan that I did from Darkstalkers. Her character design just defies the laws of gravity. So in real life, that was a pain. Just trying to, I had like these huge wings on the back of me and then on my head. So I had to like sidestep everywhere that I went. And then people were taking pictures with me and they'd like bump into my head wings. And it was just chaos everywhere, and I wore that outfit like twice and then never again, and it took me like 6 months to make it. So
yeah, that's a very long time.
Yeah.
Speaking of, since you mentioned Darkstalkers, I'm assuming that you're a gamer. What are some of the video games that, you know, you may be currently playing? Favorite video game of all time, any of that? So
Favorite video game of all time, Kingdom Hearts. I absolutely love Kingdom Hearts series, crazy about it. I also love the Paper Mario series, Harvest Moon, anything Harvest Moon, Rune Factory. I kind of collect them now since I don't really have that much time to play it. I really love RPGs and first-person shooters. I used to be really into shooter games way back in the day, more like towards my high school days, back when Xbox was like the thing to play. I was on Gears of War online playing, you know, straight up like chainsaw killing everybody. And you know, people would like try to boot me out of the game because they're like, oh, that's cheating. It's like my fault, I'm good with a chainsaw.
Yeah. It's kind of off, not really off topic, but within what you were talking about, video games, did they ever mention that you sounded like a little boy? I mean, you know, being a girl or whatever, because I play a lot of Xbox Live, PS, and whatever, and it's always those little kids that sound like, I'm like, are you a little girl? They're like, no, I'm like a 10-year-old boy. I mean, have you ever got mistaken for that?
Yeah, if I had like a dollar for every time somebody told me that while I was playing online, I got that all the time, like, you sound like a little boy, get out of this game, or you're a girl, you suck, and you know, and then I chainsaw kill them. And then they get even more mad, you know. And then so I do have kind of like the squeaky voice. So I'd be like, I curse like a sailor. So I would be like, fuck you, man. Fuck you up when I find you. And, you know, I'll just totally, I'm sorry, I'm cursing here.
Nah, it's all good.
You can just be like, bleep, bleep, bleep. Yeah. But definitely, I did get that a lot. That was probably one of the most annoying things, were playing online. And I think that's why now I'm more, I really enjoy playing on my PlayStation 3. I have a PS4 now, but they haven't came out with it. I really only got it because I'm waiting for Kingdom Hearts 3. And they keep pushing it. They keep playing with my heart. All right, that's fine. Yeah, so right now, for the PlayStation 3, I play Ni No Kuni. Loved it. Absolutely loved it. Such a good game. It wasn't long enough. I also played, what was I going to say? Oh, I started playing XCOM because I had it free for a download. It's so good and addicting. Holy crap. I had no idea it was that good.
That's cool. I guess, where can people find you out? You know, any social networks you want to throw out there for your adoring fans, you know?
Yeah, you guys can follow me on my Facebook page, facebook.com/MarieDollCosplay. Or you can go to my website, MarieDoll.com. And towards the bottom of the page, it has links to my Twitter and YouTube and all that fancy stuff.
All right, sounds good. And she mentioned about Kingdom Hearts 3 playing with her heart. Baby, I won't play with your heart.
Oh. I don't believe that.
We'll find that out.